Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with Operation Global Enforcement. Now, I have actually, at this point, already completed mission control, and I just decided that I will actually complete these two missions and any further missions that these two missions spawn before I go ahead and release mission control to you guys, because otherwise it just sort of messes with the flow of the story, because these are more like side missions, while this is the main concern that we have been following thus far, and it leads all the way up to Scorched Earth. So for this mission today, we have, that is High Command, has chosen for us mission Steel Coffin, wherein several United Freedom Armor units have been spotted near Rudney. Locate them and lace the units for divisional artillery. Now these are the kinds of missions that I like. You can just lay back on top of a hill and just lace the targets for destruction. My favorite kinds of missions, actually. So, yeah, let's go ahead and do this.
This morning, a KH-12 overflight detected several Soviet-era tanks in a UF compound located 17 kilometers east of the city of Rudny. Command wants this armor dealt with immediately. You are ordered to proceed to the objective and destroy the tanks. Your insertion point is 450 meters southwest of the objective. Bravo team will get into position and lays the targets for artillery bombardment. Alpha team will take up an overwatch position at the perimeter. Rendezvous with Black Widow north of the target for extraction. All of the armor must be eliminated. If artillery fails, you'll need to move in and finish off the targets with laws or satchel charges. Good luck.
Right, so I guess this is one of those kinds of missions where we will have to carry satchel charges. Thankfully, they actually work in this game. Now, they are recommending that we use the MP5. However, the way I'm planning to play this mission is that I'll go up to this plateau here and just lace the targets from here. Somewhere here or here, or maybe even here. Anywhere but the recommended path through the actual danger. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just climb up to this hill here and just use artillery to take out all the targets, and should that fail, then I'll move in and try and use my satchel charges, or maybe I should just carry loss. Let's see how it goes with loss. I think tanks should take more shots though, because the last time around I tried using the loss with the MiG, it did not actually work out. So with that in mind, I will be switching over to the sniper rifle, because I do believe it is a far better option. So I'll still carry a law, and I should get two rounds of ammunition with this and two rounds of satchel charges. Two satchel charges. I think that should be enough in case we fail with the artillery strikes. So, of course, playing this mission will let us know more about how it's supposed to go. So, without further ado, let's get this. Why are the enemies so accurate on this level?
Satellite shows most of the armor on the south side of the base. Concentrate your strike there.
Like, the enemies are so accurate in this level. My god. Why are they so accurate in this level? They're not supposed to be so accurate in this level. Why? It's like, every single shot gets you every single time. Without exception.
Someone, I have eyes on objective zombie. There are three towers with guards, some tanks, I count four parked outside.
Come on, move. That guy's down. Where was the other one? I see another person there. It's like, unless you're moving them out smoothly, the game just skips a few pixels for you. And I'm just trying to find a new place to shoot the enemies down from. And that's pretty much it. These guys have not showed up yet. I hope it remains that way. I see more people, but I do not think they will be an issue. I'm just looking for soldiers that will stand and shoot. And those are typically the guys that have been doing me in thus far. Combine the 90s sound capabilities with that, and you've got Delta Force. That's a BRDM. Not exactly a tank, but still a... well, an armoured vehicle, is what I would say. But what I want to do first is I want to take out the BRDMs. Where are these guys? There you are. Not so alive now, are you? Any closer and those guys are practically at an advantage, so I'm not really gonna go get as close to them. Finally dead. And there's another guy over there. Who somehow did not realize that he's been shot at. I should probably zero into a lower number. Dead. Fine. Now, since we're here already, maybe we can start attacking the damn tanks. Or can we? I hear somebody over there, so I'll just try and take these guys out first. How are you not dead, sir? I shot you like multiple times. How are you not dead? Somebody was shooting at me from all the way in the distance, and they're not shooting at me anymore, but they were shooting at me from distance. So what I'll do is I'll get up over onto this hill here. I heard somebody else shouting, and I feel like that guy's pretty close, whoever that was shouting back there. But I'll just head over onto this side. There's also grass here. Hold on. Did somebody just say hold on? No. I don't want to hold on, fuck you. Let me shoot this tree out first, it's getting in the way. Thank you. Now then, all of these can be taken out using, well...
This is King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Fire mission sent. I'll take these tanks out and then I'll proceed to taking the BRDMs out. Although I should probably be doing it the other way around, but yeah. We just need to hold the aim until the artillery arrives. Now, turn for you guys.
King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, they're making a run for the tanks. Over.
They won't get to them. The BRDMs do start moving though, so yeah. Four tanks parked outside with two BRDMs, from the looks of it. It's like an armored division right here. And that hopefully covered all the tanks, but I don't think it did, because I think there are more tanks out there that we need to take out. I see like a couple of folks here that need taking out, and it's just that. Let's take them out while they're still young and incapable of defending themselves. That's my philosophy at least. I hear more folks down there. They're making a run for the tanks apparently. Now the BRDMs that we had seen previously don't stay there, they move out of the way. So I think there are tanks inside the hangars as well, and we just need vantage points on them, and that's all we really need. So here we are, trying to find good vantage points on the tanks. Bad part about this terrain face is that it's bald. There is no grass here, meaning that enemies can see us from afar and start shooting. So, on that tower? I see. Thank you for coming, but you were ultimately useless in this battle. Good thing that those enemies can't see me right now. Is that a tree or is that a vehicle? It's just a tree. So, yeah, that was four tanks. But I think there are more tanks inside those hangars there. At least from what I remember from that brief moment when the walls disappeared momentarily. So yeah, we need to make it to that side. Hopefully without dying. I'm just gonna prone here until the frames return. This mission has been frustrating if nothing else. Primarily because of the frequency with which you tend to die. Die very often in this mission. I heard some people shooting at me from pretty close by, and another frustrating part about this mission is how there's literally no indication of
King 6, Alpha 1, Bravo's approaching the target, we are on station.
It does not give you any information about where the enemies are. All you can utilize is sound. And sound is like a pretty bad indicator. Of where the enemies are, actually. That's the last thing that I would want to use to locate the enemy. Now, the only reason that I'm proning here is so that I have some cover, because this is more or less pretty open terrain. And I do not exactly want to poke my head out too much or risk it getting shot. At the same time, there are hostiles there, we know about that. I'm going to hug this side and run. I think most of the enemies, if any, were over on that side. Cannot see any over here on the star. This mission sounded much simpler in theory. It's far more difficult in reality though. Somebody right in front of me from the... apparently. Oh, right on top of the tower. Really? I'm going to crawl up and see if there is any. I don't know why this guy crawls forward so slow. Sidewards, all okay. No worries. Like, you can crawl as fast as you can, humanly. But forwards, backwards too, it's like he crawls very fast. But forwards is where he has an issue. It's like he can't crawl forwards. He has not been trained to do that. He skipped the day when they were teaching how to crawl forwards. Just that specific day. The rest of the days he was there. I still can't see inside that building, which is very unfortunate. Alpha 1 and 2, I'll be joining you. For a better vantage point, that is. Here's to hoping that I don't get shot out by some random dude with a Kalashnikov. I think I have eyes on target. We just need to destroy the tanks as well. I guess a BRDM is also considered a tank. That's one BRDM out of commission. I can't tell whether that is a tank or whether it is something else. I don't think I can see any more tanks here. Unless we have to take out all the vehicles here. In which case, I don't know what's supposed to happen. All the four tanks have been destroyed, so why are we still here? I wonder. Is that a tank? You know, I think it is. Yes, it is. Yes, it is a tank. And it's looking right at us. I'm going to try using the law to take this tank out, once my frames return, of course. And if not the tank, then at least it'll take out the guy next to the tank. That I do believe worked for the better. I don't think I see any more tanks though. Are there any more tanks left? What is that thing there? Is that a tank? Oh no, are we out of loss? Oh well, artillery strike it is then. Whoops. Yeah, that's a BRDM. That's not a tank, that's a BRDM. Oh, and that is another garage there, isn't it? That's a Morris garage. Should have just brought the laws, because apparently...
This is King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
I guess as long as we're here, it's fine. Come on!
King 6, this is Alpha 1. We have eliminated all targets.
Roger that. All King elements proceed to rendezvous with Black Widow.
Finally. Let's just hope that I don't get shot by this guy with the lucky trigger finger. Or die to fall damage. This is where we're supposed to go, right? Why are Alpha 1 and 2 heading inside? This is our extraction. This way is our extraction, come on. You guys need to leave. Alpha. Alpha team. Extract. Extract. The mission is over, Alpha. There's no more to be done. Nothing more can be done there. Come on, Alpha. We need to extract. I guess they went in for a final kill, huh? Because they got to see no action. I mean, I suppose such is the soul of a soldier. Or a warrior, rather. Always itching for combat. But there's a very good reason I'm sneaking down the route like this, so that I don't suffer any fall damage on the way down. Because that is a very real thing in this game. And it sucks. Alpha 1, it's good to see you. Alpha 2, you're over there somewhere. Ah, up on that tree. King 6, this is Bravo 1. I am RTB, over and out. That mission sucked. That mission sucked, honestly. I mean, the enemies were way too accurate to make that mission enjoyable. I mean, typically these missions are legion trolls, but in this case it sucked. Anyhow, that was that for Mission Steel Coffin. Could have been executed far better, but it is what it is, I suppose. Yeah. So, the next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Knockout, which I'll try and figure out what that is. But as for today's video, this is it. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. I sort of got frustrated playing this mission. It's a very simple mission, but it's also very frustrating with just how accurate the enemy is. Luckily, near the end is when the enemy was not accurate. It's sort of like the developers punish you for not taking the intended route or not taking the route that they gave you, because it's like, anywhere else, if I just deviated from the route slightly, enemies could hit me with their first shot and I would be dead. So I don't really know what's up with that, but oh well, that mission is out of the way, so I'm thankful for that. And that's just how frustrating of a mission it was. So the next time we come back, we'll be covering Mission Knockout. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.